Asakurayo fails to stay up against Faust and Eliza and leaves his chance of staying in the tournament to the third match scheduled against Tao Ren. And I have a lot to say about this episode, and it will not be pretty at all, especially after coming out of a half of a dozen good to great episodes back to back. Welcome to GamerTurks Onsen, and let's talk about Shaman King 2021, Episode 7, A Form of Courage. I am alone today, had schedule issues with Val, and what a coincidence that the second video I'm doing without Val is also the second episode that I was incredibly disappointed by, the first one being the very first episode that I also recorded solo. So, you all know who to blame next time we get a bad episode in Shaman King. But why am I opening up a video so negatively and potentially inviting the dislikes right out of the gate? It's a combination of things, really. Faust is one of my favorite three characters in Shaman King. The contents of this episode is among my top favorites in the entire series. Character portrayals of the specific characters featured in this episode, these scenes, they are one of the best for these characters, featuring a huge range from everyone, yet it comes down to this mess of an episode. Honestly, those of you SAO people who have been following me for a while, this episode left me as disappointed as Kirito's nightmare episode, just utterly let down by every single moment featured, more crushed and defeated than the bones scattered around in this episode. But yeah, enough ranting, let's just get into the contents of the episode. We're starting the same way the original anime started, of course, in the cafe with Silva and Anna talking about Faust and how Yo should retreat. And these scenes, they did cause me to be a little bit afraid towards the episode, but we have had 5 to 6 episodes that were extremely good, despite being this fast and skipping some minor things, so I didn't pay much attention. You know, what could possibly go wrong? We had a good streak so far, this can go just fine as well. But then we had our introduction to Faust, which is, again, I do have a complaint, but it is an incredible personal situation here that is not relevant to the series. You know, I was gonna talk about here how Faust's voice is much more different than what I think as an ideal Faust, but as I said, that was very much a personal opinion from me, because I grew up with the dub where Faust had a much more unsettling voice, whereas this Japanese voice actor that played him 20 years ago is the exact same one here. It's actually Sugo Nobuyuki from SAO, the Fairy King Oberon, as you'll recognize, that despicable human being. But yeah, you know, it was, again, something I could just gloss over because it was so blatantly my personal opinion. It wasn't the voice I expected. Fine, that's on me. But then we actually started moving on, the OP happened, and after the OP, I really started to get suspicious. You see, this episode, I am gonna start with the animation. Very early on, right after the OP, the episode made it very clear that it was aiming to be a budget episode. We have multiple freeze frames, well, not freeze frames, there's still the rain effects happening, and you can see the lighting change a little in the background, etc., you know, those kinds of stuff. But you know, it was still a still frame of the character just standing very much still for about 10 seconds as the audio just rolled. You know, things you don't mind so much in shonen shows. There's a lot of talking to just bring down the amount of effort that's required to animate. But when things like this started happening, where Faust is just looking back and his mouth is behind his shoulder, so you don't even see the mouth move and it's entirely still, it's a sign that something is happening here. And oh my, something bad did indeed happen. It got to such a point towards the end of the episode where we have a scene with Yo, I'll just put it up here in the background. That is not me using a freeze frame, that is literally what the episode is showing you. Even the light effect is frozen because it is an actual still frame. Oh my god, how does this happen? How does one go so budget that they decide not to animate anything at all? You know, those light effects, those are just effects. You can keep them rolling, they wouldn't do much. That's not actual drawing, animating you have to do. But again, I can go on and on and on about the animation. There are so many weirdly drawn scenes. There are so many weird camera angles and very undetailed drawings, etc., etc., those kinds of stuff, you know. The animation this episode, it was bad. It wasn't just budget, it was bad. But you know, bad animation, it can happen. It's a weekly show, they have been doing a lot. It's not the AAA kind of series, something like your SAO, your My Hero Academia, your, I don't know, Attack on Titan, is Shaman King. It was once huge, it's not as big as it was all those years ago. So, yeah, you can have badly animated episodes, but then let's move on to the contents. You see, this episode is a prime example where I'm just gonna say the same as I said back in episode 1, just go watch the damn original. That was 20 years ago and that episode has a whole lot more context, a whole lot more intensity, a whole lot more great character portrayals for both Faust, for Yo, for Anna, for Silva, for the fucking eagle guy. This episode felt like we had a 30-minute episode in our hands, but it got into the studio, they just trimmed out a whole bunch, and we are just jump cutting from scene to scene, in the middle of scenes, into middle of animations, etc, etc. It was honestly a mind-boggling experience. I don't know how to keep things structured without having a script as I do in my other videos, but I have been doing Shaman King without a script with Val, so it is continuing without a script, so you're gonna have to listen to me rant for a little bit more. You see, one of the things I absolutely loved about the Faust episode back in the original anime was that we had a huge amount of time where Faust was really dicking around with both Manta and Yo to really tire out Yo, to win the fight before it even began. What happens in this episode? We have a 1 minute of just clashing sounds, like 5 or 6 times the camera just rolled upwards looking at the rain. And we had like 5 or 6 sword clashes implying bones being broken. We just didn't get the sense of Yo really exhausting himself before the battle even began. And on the opposite side, when Yo started really playing mind games on Faust, it was the exact same. We didn't get the sense of Faust just breaking down bit by bit as he's being played around by Yo, because it's just happening so fast. Within 10 seconds, Faust went from entirely in control of everything to fucking Sugo Nobuyuki, and I have to give credit to his voice actor. It was the exact same performance he has as Sugo Nobuyuki, and it really fits the moment. I'll credit where credit is due. That really did work. However, that transition, we never get the sense of building up into something. Yo is like, I know how I'm gonna win this. Hey, Faust, I am not gonna play with your doll. Haha, I'm gonna win now because I just said the thing and you go crazy. It doesn't work. Give us build-ups. Give us payoffs to build-ups that you built up to. It's just such a hollow episode as a whole in regards to context as well. As a kid, you know, I was really mad when things got broken up into 2 separate episodes because, you know, you have school and stuff and fucking TV schedules never work the way you expect them. Suddenly, you end up missing an episode and boom, the entire context is gone. I hate having things broken up into 2 episodes, especially as a kid, I used to. But come on, this was very obviously in a terrible need of a broken up episode into 2, or at least a long episode of 30 minutes. But yeah, let's not all be doom and gloom. Another one of those things I have really enjoyed in the episode was Anna just going back in Yo's history. That was a really neat moment, giving some really nice background into how Yo was not exactly having the best childhood, etc. Those kinds of stuff, you know. It's always nice having to see your... nice, I say. You know what I mean. It's always good to have more background on your main character. How it's... They are not exactly the best person around, you know. They have something that shape them up to be the person they are. Let's put it that way. Yeah, those moments, they're always appreciated, you know? I mean, more than appreciated, they are among my favorite moments when the main character gets really shaped up in a nice way. And I really love how it goes into Yo being always this person that was excluded from everything and then found a friendship in Manta, and that's why they stuck together that way. And that's why Yo put so much effort into protecting Manta no matter the outcome. And again, Amidamaru mentions that entire thing at the end of this episode, and I can't believe I chuckled in that scene. It was a great scene on its own, but it was so terribly put together in this episode that it just falls apart. Whenever I try saying something positive about this episode, it just reaches a point where it falls apart and never pays off. So yeah, I guess there's not much point continuing for too long. I'm just gonna keep repeating the same things over and over. So just to summarize in a very short bit, this episode had characters pushed to their absolute limits, but never show the characters actually getting pushed to their absolute limits. And you know, there was incredible promise for everything, but it was never built up, it was never paid off. It's just like, even Silva trying to rush in a last ditch effort to save Yo from something unexpected, it just looks so bad, so lazy, so passionless compared to what we had in the original, where Silva was just opening up his wings to their absolute best, going straight against this gigantic bone monster. I have to ask, where did it all go wrong? And of course, it went wrong back at the pre-production when they allocated so little amount of episodes to the entire show. But come on, there's no excuse for this. Either way, thank you very much for watching. I'm GamerTurk, all thanks to my patrons. Hopefully next week, well, we'll be back and we won't have any more of these terrible episodes, because that was just... it really broke my heart. I can't explain it any other way. It just broke my heart. And that's... I don't even know, man. Like, Faust explaining his backstory. That entire backstory, it feels like I am watching a YouTube video explaining Faust's backstory in a single minute, running at double the speed in the video player. Everything was wrong in this episode. It broke my heart. And I'll just try to forget this episode ever existed, and now I'll go watch the two episodes from the original anime where Faust was introduced. Thank you, bye bye.